Facial recognition technology doesn't work very well if people are wearing masks, like many of us right now. But masks aside, there are major concerns over just how accurate this technology really is anyway.
NBC2 investigator Evan Dean is finding out if you could be arrested for a crime you never committed.
And your flight is one of the first departures using facial recognition technology from curb to gate.
From catching a flight to clicking on Facebook, facial recognition technology is on the rise. Also on the rise are concerns about the technology and if it's really all that accurate, especially when it's being used by law enforcement agencies to try to solve crimes captured on camera.
The artificial intelligence that's available is not quite at the standard of what it needs to be.
That's local tech expert Evan Lutz, who talked with us about the fallout of facial recognition. Last month, lawmakers in D.C. proposed a bill to ban the federal government from using it. And certain companies that make it said they'll stop selling it to police agencies unless Congress better regulates it.
I can't breathe!
The biggest concern with the technology is the same concern seen across America right now: racial bias. A government-led study found facial recognition algorithms were far more likely to misidentify black faces than whites.
I mean, I know they got the wrong guy immediately, like, I'm no thief.
Robert Williams fell victim to this very flaw. Detroit police wrongfully arrested him after the software matched his driver's license photo to surveillance video of someone stealing from a watch store.
So I picked that one up sarcastically and put it to my face. And I said, I hope you don't think all black people look alike, and dropped it back on the table. And he flipped the third piece of paper, irritated, and said, so I guess the computer got it wrong.
Sometimes we just need to slow down and making sure that we're doing our due diligence and make sure that we're doing more good than harm in the process.
For the NBC2 Investigators, I'm Evan Dean.
We reached out to our police agencies to see if they use this technology. Cape Coral PD says they do not. The Collier County Sheriff's Office does. They use a program through Pinellas County, but they say it's only for generating leads, not for positive identifications. We're still waiting to hear back from other departments.